Welcome to the Riverside Arena at London's Olympic Park for this eagerly awaited Pool A game between Great Britain and Argentina. It's day one of the men's hockey. The tournament consists of two pools of six. The pools are based on the world rankings, ensuring that the top two teams in the world are not drawn in the same group. Well, it's the top two who progress to the semi-finals, so Great Britain rank four would be expected to go through, but Argentina and Spain will push them hard. Australia ranked one in the world, Germany two, and Netherlands three. There's a full house here at the Riverside Arena. Clamour for local success after Great Britain finished fifth at the 2008 Olympic Games, but this time hoping to medal. Great Britain hoping to recreate the glory days of the 1988 Olympics when they took gold behind Germany and the Netherlands. The star of that team, Sean Kearley, is here as part of the local commentary team. And you have to go back to Antwerp in the 1920 Olympic Games to find Great Britain's previous gold. And the first time hockey was introduced into the Olympics in London, Great Britain took gold then as well. Great Britain in the white jerseys. So the team's being introduced here. James Tindall from Surbiton. James Fair, one of the experienced members of this Great Britain men's hockey team. So here the Argentina team, 260 international caps for Villa. Camereri, who played at the 2004 Olympics, nicknamed the Cat. So the two teams have been introduced to the crowd now. So now the national anthems of the two countries. This is a key match in Pool A, which also includes Australia, Spain, Pakistan and South Africa. Here the Great Britain lineup. Three players have scored more than 200 goals between them. Ashley Jackson, Captain Barry Middleton and James Tindall. Remember, rolling substitutions allowed at any stage during the game. Plenty of experience for Argentina with Matias Villa, number four. He's played 260 times for his country. But this is going to be a tough game for Argentina, ranked lower than Great Britain. Argentina ranked ninth in the world, Great Britain four, so in theory, it should be Great Britain's day, especially with a large partisan crowd cheering them on. Two umpires, one from India, one from Germany. Time, gentlemen, please. Very shortly, Great Britain's Olympic Games hockey campaign for men will be underway. This has been a long time in the waiting. Great Britain start the game in the white shirts. They just missed out on a semi-final place in Beijing, finishing fifth. 17 with the sideline put in is Juan Martin Lopez. Aerial ball. Not an easy one to defend. Was an infringement. Brunei. Under pressure immediately though by number 13, Robert Moore. Classic U-shaped defence. Argentina trying to work the ball out diligently, but they've lost possession here. Great Britain on the front foot. Hit a foot. Free hit to Argentina. Argentinian coach Pablo Lombi, who was a member of the Argentina team at the 92 and 96 Olympic Games. That's terrific play. Ben Hall's doing really well. Argentina a counter-attack here though through Camareri. Rey. That's an infringement. Should be a 5-yard exclusion zone. Argentina will try again with Rey. Five here is Ibarra. 17, the left back. Lopez has to go backwards. Good pressure by Team GB. Camareri. Lopez. Great interception there. But GB give it back to Argentina. Villa. Just outside the 23-metre line. Right. Bit of pushing and shoving going on inside the D. The Indian official just telling them to just cut it out. Deflection and just put wide there. What a great chance for Argentina to take the lead with Juan Martin Lopez. First real opportunity of the game goes Argentina's way. Crowd getting behind Team GB, but and they have their own band as well. To say that Argentina have begun the game more brightly of the two teams. Caglioni. Oh, seemed to be impeded there. He's looking for a free hit. Rather quizzical look towards the umpire. Well, just seemed to be an infringement there by Ben Hawes, who used the stick, made contact with a player. Any contact with a player with a stick results in a free hit. But Great Britain now can counter-attack, and they've lost their way again. It wasn't a great ball. Jason Lee, who wanted a cold August to give his team an advantage. It's a breezy end of July. Ben Hawes. No way through that time for James Tindall. Great Britain guilty of giving the ball away far too many times. Argentina taking full advantage, but Great Britain win it back. Jackson. Two waiting in the middle, including Daly. Opening goal for Great Britain. Matthew Daly, the man who's been struggling with an injury for many months, gives Great Britain's men's hockey team the advantage. You'd have to say it's against a run of play. His 58th international goal. And there's an appeal by Argentina. So it's gone to the video referee. And the goal is chalked off. The video referral was upheld. To say, didn't seem very obvious why the goal was chalked out. Remains 0-0. Aerial ball, that's just far too difficult to take. Good attempt nonetheless by Nick Catlin. His first Olympic Games. I only think that the goal was chalked out because the ball had hit the foot of Daly. Seemed no other explanation. Argentina seemed pretty certain it wasn't an authentic goal, and it remains 0-0. Ashley Jackson. Oh, clever little ball by Jackson. Hopeful ball into the middle. Turned out for the long corner. Vivaldi doing well, taking no chances at all. It's gone straight out. Another long corner. Ashley Jackson. Camerari picks out Villa. Hopeful cross, it just whizzed across the D. More in hope than accuracy. Dangerous ball nonetheless. And the reason the ball is fired across with such alacrity is in the hope that it's going to hit the foot of a defender. So Great Britain have been denied a goal on the video referral remains goalless. They play that U-shaped passing move to their left back position. Oh, the ball superbly won back there by Villa, Lucas Martin Villa, gold medalist at the Pan American Games in 2011. As England, this team won the 2010 Champions Trophy and bronze at the 2011 European Championships in Germany. Their tactics, they say, is all-out attack. Coach Jason Little says it is high risk. I'd say it's been pretty even so far, apart from that one chance which Daly converted, but later chalked out. Little mazy run here. Sixteen-yarder. Argentina restart the game. This is Ibarra. Finished top goalscorer at the World Cup qualifying tournament in Quilmes. Another loose ball. Really has been disappointing. Be a sideline ball here to Argentina. Ibarra to restart the game, an aerial ball. See the rolling substitutions on the touchline. Matias Damian Villa waiting to come on for Argentina. But Great Britain are having to be pretty patient here. No green card at the moment. That's well worked by Great Britain. Can they convert here? Beaten away by Vivaldi. Ball still hasn't been cleared. It's out for the long corner, I think. Just rescued at the last there by Rossi, and he tries to relieve the pressure. Mazzilli. Ray, that's a good ball. Picks up Paredes. He's played 200 international games for Argentina. That's a neat turn. Dragged back. Goalkeeper James Fair made an important save there. Daly has it now for Great Britain. Here's the counter-attack. Can they sweep forward quickly? Access of the attack has been disrupted. Martin swept on quickly there by Daniel Fox, and on again by Kirkham. Lewis. Hopeful ball into a D. That's a neat layoff. Almost came off as well for Harry Martin. Reverse shot. Didn't quite come off by Daly. Reverse pass there. Almost did the requisite damage. Wilson in attendance. Block tackle. Eventually the ball cleared. But they were fighting at the back there, Argentina. Now they have the ball at the other end. Reverse pass. Free hit. It's a good ball as well as Great Britain drive forward now. Martin. Good save by the goalkeeper to deny Clark. Great Britain getting in their stride again. Argentina back defending. Four here is Kirkham. It's a long corner. It wasn't put out deliberately. It would have been a penalty corner if it had. That's the pressure Argentina's defence are under at the moment. Kirkham has won the free hit. Kirkham has played more than 200 times for England. Have to go back to the dotted line here, and the ball has to travel 5 yards before anybody else can try and tackle. Hit the foot. Argentina win it back. 10 is Paredes. The longer the game is going on, the more Great Britain try to raise the tempo, try to put pressure on Argentina. Pelat. Eight here is Ray. I think that hit the foot of the Great Britain defender. Umpire didn't see it. Television camera was pretty conclusive. Lewis. Free hit to Great Britain. Try to recycle play again. That's a great ball into the middle, and there was a foul. Question is, where was it? Inside the 23, so onto the dotted line. Ball has to travel 5 yards now before anybody else can interfere. Plenty back here for Argentina, but hardly a surprise. Fortini's Hawes drags it back. Oh, it's so close! I think it was Robert Moore who got the touch. Hawes dragged it across goal. Was it number 13? Moore, who almost got the decisive touch. Indeed it was. A few lucky escapes for Argentina. Sideline hit. Great Britain once again playing the U-shaped ball across the back. Middleton, the captain. Oh, that's a mistake. Shame. Daniel Fox getting in a bit of a mess. He already has a silver medal from the Champions Trophy in 2010. Good turnover by Team GB. Ben Hawes had that terrible facial injury. Needed a metal plate inserted in his face after being hit by a ball in September 2007. On comes Wilson, Alistair Wilson. His partner Fran Halsall has represented Great Britain in swimming. Metzili Great Britain have the sideline hit. Ashley Jackson going wide. Harry Martin has made space here. This is Martin. Little turn by Martin. It didn't quite come off. Clever play by Team GB. Middleton almost linking up there, the captain. I think that ball just relieves the pressure on Argentina's overworked defence. Argentina qualified for London 2012 by winning gold at the 2011 Pan American Games in Guadalajara. It was intended for Matias Damian Villa, but it's good intervention there by Team GB, who really are warming to the task on a cool and cloudy evening. Nothing wrong with that. Well, the whistle has gone now. Great Britain claiming there was a foot. Indeed, there is a free hit just outside the 23. Great Britain come again. 14 here is Hawes. Martin muscled out of it, and Argentina can counter-attack. That's a fabulous ball. 10 here is Paredes, drags it back. Absolutely nobody inside the D, but he was looking to hit a Great Britain foot and win a penalty corner. Nothing doing, hasn't been a penalty corner so far in this match. Great athleticism by Paredes to hook the ball back. To the untrained eye, that might look like a little more than a hopeful ball in, but they know what they're doing. Great Britain have the free hit now. Off goes Bergner. Great Britain attack here. Great Britain claim it hit an Argentinian foot. And indeed, the referee has given it. Didn't see it, helped by his umpire. Catlin just trying to confirm exactly what the referee's given here. Well, there was a player impeded, and then it hit the foot quite clearly there of number 28, Belliet. So penalty corner to Great Britain, a great chance now to score the opening goal of this game. Green card for Bergner. First penalty corner of the match. Hawes waiting. I imagine he'll be the stopper. Great save by the goalkeeper, Vivaldi. And Great Britain take the lead. Vivaldi couldn't keep that out. That's going to count. Great Britain's opening goal at the men's hockey. And it's the captain, Barry Middleton, who leads by example. Watch the save here by the goalkeeper. Middleton was on hand. Not an easy chance by any stretch of the imagination. Middleton from a tight angle. Almost a reverse hit. Just skim the goalkeeper's forearm. And now Middleton has scored 76 international goals. Thank you. So can Argentina find a way back into this one? Pelat. Lopez. 16-yard restart. Lopez. Is that Great Britain goal again? Definitely Middleton's goal. Although the official timekeeper says Matthew Daly scored. Certainly wasn't Daly's, although he was quick into the ruck of players to congratulate his captain. Middleton makes it 1-0. Camilleri waiting to come on for Argentina. Great Britain worth that goal. There was plenty of pressure building up on Argentina leading to it. And that's a great intervention. Well played, sir. Ian Lewis getting the ball and then giving it away. Great chance for Argentina to draw level. Whistle's gone. Referee spotted something here. Infringement goes the way of Team GB. 14 is Ben Horse. I think it struck the foot there of Tindall. Here come Team GB again. That's a great ball in towards Ashley Jackson. Jackson trying to turn, can't get the shot away. Mackay couldn't follow up. It's cleared here by Rossi. And here comes Argentina on the counter-attack as the sun comes out at the Riverbank Arena. Full house here for Great Britain in white against Argentina. Slightly less than 10 minutes remaining of the first half. 35 minutes each way, of course. 10-minute interval. Fox doing his best. The result is a long corner. Look how deep Argentina have to regroup here and pick out Pedro Ibarra. Hopeful ball into the middle. Almost won back there by Caglioni. Great Britain relieve the pressure, and that's a really good ball. And here they come again. 20 is Tindall. And look at this ball by Tindall. Picks out Ashley Jackson. Well, so close to 2-0. Can't repeat what he said as he got up. That's an outstanding stop from the goalkeeper, Vivaldi. Old man of the team at 33, Vivaldi, but my goodness, he's earning his crust tonight. Sideline hit here for Team GB. Montelli seemed to be barged as he released the ball. Picks out Ray. Ray going back to his central defender. 24 is Brunet. Team GB counter-attack again. Montelli with that long ball. Changes the axis of the attack. Camilleri. Free hit to Team GB. Jackson forcing the ball on. 23 there is Mackay. Harry Martin now back on for Team GB. Mackay, now where's he going to go? Team GB trying to work the ball inside the 23, but they have to go backwards. Fine play by Hawes. Nine here is Martin. I think the goalkeeper requires a little bit of attention here. I can only think that it was when Great Britain scored their goal, because the ball definitely flicked against the arm of Vivaldi, who's something of a hockey coach these days. Maybe he's looking eventually to take over his job. Doesn't look too serious a problem for Juan Manuel Vivaldi. Also coached in the Netherlands. He also made a very good stop to deny a second GB goal with his arm, and I just wonder whether it was that incident which saw him slightly damage his forearm. Clock is stopped at just less than 7 minutes. Did it hit the foot of the GB man? The answer is no. Ray has it. Long ball forward. It's a good one as well. And Argentina are through here. Great chance here for Caglione. Well, he almost made it 1-1. James Fair to the rescue for Team GB. Caglione through here. I think the goalkeeper had that covered. Ball deflected out for a long corner. Only one penalty corner so far. Great Britain ultimately scored from that. That's great dribbling play by Harry Martin. Just couldn't pick out a white shirt. Martin's won it back here. Ball still loose. Kick clear by Vivaldi. Long corner again. No way through that time for Mackay. Another long corner. Remember, as a defender, you can't intentionally put the ball out across your own back line. That would be a penalty corner. The ball is deflected out. It's a long corner. Only the goalkeepers are allowed to kick the ball. Diving figure there of Ashley Jackson, who scored 2 goals against Argentina in the last meeting. Game which Argentina won by 3-2. Able to get on the end of that one though. Tindall wins the long corner. Reverse pass. Wasn't a bad idea. Quickly taken long corner. Not long now left of this first half. I think the important thing here for Team GB and their coach Jason Lee is to keep it tight in these last few minutes and have an advantage at the break. Oh, that was a difficult one to control. Harry Martin did his best. One of the least experienced players in this group. An aerial ball. Well controlled. Powerful burst there by Pinner, who's come on for Team GB. More pressure from the team in white. Almost a turnover of play. Sideline hit here for Team GB. No wonder there's consternation on the faces of the team in blue. Jason Lee in radio communication with his bench. Can Team GB medal here at their home Olympics? 26 is Metsili. Reverse pass by Metsili. Yard restart. Well, initially, Ashley Jackson lost the ball and then committed the foul. So Argentina with a late opportunity perhaps to put some pressure on the GB goal before the break. Perhaps find an equaliser. Was there a foul there on Villa? Indeed there was. Goes to the dotted line. Foul inside the 23. Ball has to travel 5 metres before anybody can intervene in white. Long corner, I think, here for Argentina. Indeed it is. Seemed to be a stick foul then. And indeed it was. Free hit to Team GB. Metsili, the offending player. Wonder if Team GB can just run the clock down now. Bit of a stretch. Turned on by Pinner. Pinner wearing the number one jersey, though he's not the goalkeeper. It's a lovely dummy. Ray. Surely there wasn't a 5 metre, oh dear, 5 metre exclusion then, and green card coming out. Quite rightly so. Catlin green carded. Just wouldn't retreat the statutory 5 metres. So he takes a breather. We're inside the final minute of the first half. Lopez. Pinner. Oh, that's going to be a foul. And the Argentina man is going to make the most of it here, and it's getting a little bit heated. I wonder if the two umpires are going to take a strong view on that. There's a little bit of ill feeling creeping into this game. That powerful shove there by Matt Daly. Both sticks went flying, as did Ibarra. It's getting a bit tasty. A free hit to Argentina as they try find a late equaliser right on the hooter and able to do so. Well, it's been bruising and it's been pretty tight, but the only goal scored by the GB captain Barry Middleton. Great Britain had a goal chalked off on video appeal, but at half time it's Great Britain 1, Argentina 0. Finer points of the game and the rules being discussed there. Middleton on target after 22 minutes. So the PA announcer explaining why the GB goal was chalked out, that first one. And it was because the ball had struck the body of the Team GB player. and on video appeal, the appeal was upheld. Grey skies overhead. Some of the Great Britain interplay was quite delightful. Vivaldi's been busy in the Argentina goal, pushing the ball away there. Bit of a scramble there as Argentina went seeking the opening goal. Montelli almost in. Clark with this reverse hit.
They're ranked number one in the world. They're in our group, so that's going to be a very, very big game here on Sunday. But having said that, our last sort of
diving effort on goal, just wide of target. Lovely play here by Ben Hawes, dragging the ball across the D. Robert Moore unable to convert the chance. Paredes whipping the ball across here. It's a really good piece of play by Argentina. Here's the goal, hacked in by Middleton. Captain leading by example. Bailey was the stopper. Middleton with not an easy chance, helping the ball down, but just flick the forearm of Juan Manuel Vivaldi. Helpful ball by Tindall. Nobody to get on the end of it despite that lunge by Ashley Jackson. Right at the end, Ibarra went flying under that challenge by Daly. Tempers were just becoming a little bit flared. Here the match statistics then. No penalty corners yet for Argentina. Great Britain with 8 attempts on goal to Argentina's 2. Plenty of local colour and support in what has been a disappointing afternoon for Great Britain, with Tom Daly disappointing in the diving competition. And the Great Britain fans hoping that the men's hockey team can provide a little bit of cheer. One of the most intriguing aspects of this stadium is none of it's undercover, not even our broadcast commentary positions. Only that top section there, which is reserved for the relatives of the athletes. London 2012 is the first world event to be played on a different coloured synthetic turf to the traditional green. This 15,000 capacity Riverbank Arena with this blue and pink pitches, which are intended to provide better contrast to the yellow ball. There are two pitches here, right next to the International Broadcasting Centre. The The main one here will stage all 76 matches, while the other one next door is used for training by the 380 competitors in the 24 men's and women's teams. Incidentally, after the games, the hockey centre will move to a 3,000-seater facility north of the park that can be intended to be extended to 15,000 for major events. If you're new to hockey, it's two 35-minute periods. We're in a 10-minute interval at the moment. In the semi-finals and final and classification matches, if the scores are level at the end of normal time, there'll be 15 minutes extra time, 7.5 minutes each way. It's sudden death extra time. The first team to score in that period wins. If no golden goal is scored, it goes to a shootout competition. Five players from each team have 8 seconds to score against the opposing goalkeeper, starting from the 23-metre line. Not sure those boys can see very much. Remy can only score from inside the D, the shooting circle. There's no offside in hockey. If a foul is committed inside the D, penalty corner can be awarded. Two umpires in hockey, one for each half of the pitch. And that green card, and we've seen a couple of them in the first half, is a 2-minute warning. It's a suspension. Player has to go off. Yellow cards, 5 minutes. Red card, permanent exclusion. Argentina caused controversy with a TV advert showing Fernando Zeibelberg in training on the Falkland Islands, or the Malvinas. The video ended with a voiceover: to compete on English soil, we're training on Argentine soil. Zeibelberg has not made the Olympic squad, so hopefully hockey is our only focus of attention. So we're just about ready and set for the start of the second half now. Thankfully the rain has held off, but you'll see plenty of ponchos and rain wear in evidence if there is a cloudburst. At half time, it's Great Britain 1, Argentina 0. It's Argentina to restart the game in what has been a rather bruising encounter so far. The only goal of the encounter on 22 minutes scored by Great Britain's Barry Middleton. Although Great Britain did have the ball in the Argentina goal, but it was chalked off after video appeal. Back underway again with Brunet. Trying to get inside the scoring circle, can't do so. It's going to be a long corner. Here is Pellet. Lopez unable to keep the ball alive. His nickname is the Cat. Hasn't quite got the milk so far. Mazzilli. Villa. Well won back by Team GB, and there was a bit of an infringement there by the Argentine captain. Harry Martin getting it wide. One met well though by Mazzilli. Here's the counter-attack by Argentina. Hopeful ball in. That's a great save by the GB goalkeeper, James Fair. He hardly had a second to react then when the ball was deflected. Look at this for a save. Almost touched in by Caglioni. Mazzilli with a shot, Caglioni with a deflection. And that struck Fair in the chest. Smile by Caglioni, he knows how close he was. Caglioni, who has struggled with injuries in his career, especially to his lower back. This is Villa. Foul on the Team GB defender. That's a great take. Sideline put in here, taken by Tindall. Tindall again, and Tindall appeared to be impeded. Referee waves play on. Team GB might be susceptible to the counter-attack here. Villa crowded out. Great Britain win possession back. Ibarra. Reverse hit. Breaks nicely now for Mazzilli. Still Mazzilli with that green stick. It's a lovely turn by Camareri. Camareri again. Appeals that it struck the arm of a Team GB player and should be a penalty corner. And Team GB have given it away. Argentina have come out very strongly at the early period of this second half. Daniel Fox helping it onwards. Sideline hit here for Great Britain. Kirkland getting it wide. Look how deep Argentina are sitting. Great Britain have to try and change the axis of attack here. And then they lose possession. It's picked up by Caglioni. Went straight out. Restart for Great Britain. Great Britain currently fourth in the world, their ranking. At a pre-Olympic test event in May, Great Britain won bronze after beating India 2-1. Clark. Hawes. Kirkham. Good interception there by Villa. Paredes. That's well played by Moore. Reverse shot, it's gone in! GB2! Argentina nil, and would you believe it, it's the captain again. What an evening he's having. Well, if anybody is playing a captain's role, he is. Right through the goalkeeper, I think Vivaldi will be disappointed with himself. No foul. Well, the foul goes GB's way. Lopez thought otherwise. That will settle a few nerves in Team GB. That's a great ball. Villa. Ashley Jackson. Oh, what a ball by Jackson. Great chance for 3-0. And it's put wide, disappointingly there, by James Tindall. The left-hander just unable to turn the ball into what would have been an unguarded goal. He knows that is a great chance to put this game to bed. All set up by a fabulous ball by Jackson. Kinnicum will leave the sideline hit. Ben Hawes. Stick hit stick, no foul though. Catlin has won it back. Catlin drags the ball back into the D, but nobody on the end of it in a white shirt. Kirkham. Looked like a foul. Argentina take it quickly and move on with Rossi. Ray. Hit the body of the GB player. Hence the free hit. Struck George Pinner, 6'4" tall. Struck the inside of his thigh. Villa lays the ball off delightfully and touched on. Montelli involved in that, turned on to Rossi. Out for the long corner, bit of pressure here by Argentina. Ray. Probably Argentina's best spell of the game. Hit the foot of the GB player. Nothing wrong with that. Block tackle didn't quite come off by Argentina. And GB happy just to release the pressure on their overworked defence. Terrific second goal by Barry Middleton. Right through the goalkeeper's legs. Argentina press again. Unable, Caglioni unable to find a way through. The whistle's gone. And a yellow card now for Daly. So he does have to sit down. That yellow card, really the result of the sort of pressure Argentina are putting GB under here. James Fair could well be called into the action any time. Bergner. Bergner again. Metsi Lee. That's good defending. Excellent defending by Team GB. Long corner here to Argentina, who are searching for their opening goal of the tournament. Metsi Lee. I think it struck the foot of Metsi Lee, and a little bit of pressure taken off the Team GB defence now. Oh, that's a fantastic take. Mackay waiting in the middle. Fine save by Vivaldi to deny Team GB a third goal, and that surely is going to be a foul. Quite blatant use of the stick. Metsi Lee sent to the dugout area. Stick violation. Doesn't look too happy, does he? So, right. Next goal is going to be crucial here. If Great Britain can find a third, surely they'd put themselves into a very strong position to take the points from this game. Argentina needs something to get back in it quickly. George Pinner now for Team GB. Pinner is free. Stick met stick. But the decision goes away of Argentina. Ibarra to take the free hit, which he has already done. Ray wins the free hit, struck the body of the Team GB player, Martin. Harry Martin, one of the rookies of the team. Richard Smith got his stick to the ball. Long corner here to Argentina. The pressure builds again. Lopez. Lopez with the sideline hit, which is allowed to take himself. Breaks here to Pinner. That's great play by Pinner. Here comes the counter-attack by Team GB. They're streaming towards that Argentina goal now. Pinner helps it on. Great opportunity for 3-0. So easy for Team GB. What a shot there by Dan Fox. Gaping hole in the Argentina defence. I said the third goal would be crucial. Dan Fox has scored it. Failing to tempt my Panades to keep Argentina moving forward, but there'll be one or two disappointed Argentine players now realising perhaps this game is up. That 3-2 success over Team GB rather in the last international will mean very little now. It's gone straight out. 16-yard restart. Bonnet unsuccessful. Great ball by Pinner. Look at the space here by Fox. Congratulated by Catlin. It's strongest country in this pool is probably Australia. Great Britain play Australia on August the 5th in the pool match. Next up for Team GB, meeting with South Africa. Ranked 12th, probably Great Britain's easiest pool game. Next up for Argentina, Pakistan on August the 1st. More goals possibly here for Team GB. Kicked away by Vivaldi. Kirkham lurking with intent, turns the ball back in. They're queuing up in the middle here. Well, the GB crowd really enjoying themselves. Struck the foot of the defender. So, penalty corner to Team GB. Great chance to make it 4-0 now. Sure, they work on this an awful lot in training. Jason Lee just checking his computer. Daly, number 10, will be the stopper here. He will stop the ball as it gets injected to the edge of the D. Daniel Fox hoping to add to the goal he's already scored. Vivaldi is ready. Robert Moore is the injector. 4-0. Looks like Harry Martin has claimed a fourth goal. It's Smith, Richard Smith. Oh, lovely penalty corner. Richard Smith, who made his international debut in 2010 for Great Britain against Argentina, has surely put this one beyond any reasonable doubt. Paredes is the captain, Villa. Paredes struck the foot of number 4, Glenn Kirkham. His uncle played hockey at under 18 level. Villa. We want 5 is the cry from the GB crowd. Free hit for Argentina, but they left the ball behind. Came off the shoulder of the GB player. That's what Argentina claim anyway. Video referral.
Dangerously from an GB stick. Can you probably prove that on the video? Yes, indeed.
You can see why Argentina are complaining. Ball flew up very dangerously towards the face of the Argentine player. John Wright, the video umpire, having a look at it.
Yes, go ahead. Okay, so we continue with the penalty corner. Okay.
Penalty corner for Argentina. It's only the third time these teams have met at the Olympic Games. So, Team GB gear up. Can Argentina reduce the deficit here? Yes, they can. Four-one now. Ibarra with that accurate low shot. Driving it low. So a little bit more of a respectable scoreline as far as Argentina are concerned. Aerial ball. GB pick it back up again. Great Britain looking for another goal. Their fifth of the evening. Oh, that was pretty close. Two players went diving in, including Daly. We've probably got the closest of the two. Ball breaks nicely here for Villa. Run out of it though by Ben Halls. Villa looking for a free hit. It is a free hit to Argentina. Plenty of time for Argentina to make a late comeback in this one. Not by any stretch of the imagination is this one completely over, especially now Argentina have got that goal from the penalty corner. Mancini got the last touch. Sideline hit here for Great Britain. Really interesting area of the game now. Do Great Britain twist or stick? 4-1 would be a very, very good start for them in the hockey tournament, especially with some bigger games still to come. That's gone out, surely. Fox knew it. Twelve and a half minutes remain. Lewis just took his eye off the ball at the vital moment. That was a really vital interception. Foul by Villa. deliberately obstructing a pennant. Pinner. Pinner lost out. Argentina counter-attack. This really is all to do with Great Britain's endurance here. How strong are they? How fit are they? Paredes, another goal now for Argentina would really set this up for a grandstand finish. Ball laid off neatly by Villa. Free hit for Team GB. Ibarra has scored Argentina's only goal so far. Aerial ball to relieve some of the pressure, but it also sets up a Team GB raid. Pinner's made a good run and good intervention there by Brunette. Well, that surely is going to be a penalty corner. No. Referee allows the advantage. The shot by Tindall goes out for the long corner. Great pressure again by Team GB. Catlin went all the way himself there. Thought the referee was going to blow for a foul, but Catlin just laid it off. Tindall had the shot. Last 10 minutes or so this opening tournament game for men's GB hockey team. More. It's well intercepted by Veer, the captain. Left the ball behind. Metzili. It's quite a cool evening now here in London. Little flick there, that's a good flick as well. And Pinner's after it. Look at the strength here. Jackson. Great burst by Ashley Jackson. Use of the elbow was spotted and Ibarra takes a break. I think he was just slamming his stick against his opponent's stick there. Didn't help his cause. Free hit to Argentina. Great Britain's defence has been pretty strong so far. Just conceding that one penalty corner. Lopez drilled back towards Brunette. No way through for Brunette. I think it struck a GB player. Go back to the dotted line. Sideline ball here for Argentina. Struck the GB player again, so again will be a free hit on the dotted line. But the umpire spotted something here. Pellet. Another counter-attack by Team GB. Containment and counter-attack is their game now. Middleton. GB in a real hurry to get on with it. And they've opened up Argentina again. Almost a way through that time for Clark. Ray, he's lost out though. Won back by Jonathan Clark again. Jackson. Ball flew up and hit the Argentine player on the body. Free hit to Team GB. Jackson. Great chance for number five. Villa gets it clear and then almost presents the ball back to Team GB. The chance has come and gone. Good save by Vivaldi. Villa. Great Britain have taken the free hit quickly. They can counter-attack here. Kirkham, oh, that's a poor ball. That's Seeley. Kirkham couldn't win it. Argentina looking for a goal to get back into this one. Kelly, and you're not too happy with the umpire there. I think he wanted to get on with the game and the umpire awarded the free hit. Ray Brunette. Matter of defence now for Team GB to hang on and claim the points. Ray. That's clever play by the Argentine. Twisting one way and then t'other. Hawes, picked up by Villa, the Argentine captain. Argentina returning to the Olympic Games after missing out on qualification for Beijing in 2008. The best ever finish to an Olympic tournament was 8th place in 1988 and 2000. The recent results by Argentina have been mixed though. Brunette. Free hit to Argentina. Time is running out for them. Villa. Very often those aerial balls are just to release the pressure. The important thing here for Team GB is not to concede again. And that's why Argentina are seeing a lot of possession now. Stick infringement. Free hit to Team GB. I think they're just trying to keep warm more than anything else. Traditional English summer's day in East London. A hint of rain. Stiff breeze. Temperatures plummeting. real heat wave in London. Happened last week before the games actually began. Caglioni not too impressed with that challenge. Did shoulder meet shoulder. Here comes the counter-attack. And that period of uncertainty surely now over as far as Team GB are concerned. They can hang on to possession. There's no way Argentina are going to find three goals late on here. Has been a good second half for Team GB. Three goals to Argentina's one. Villa's won it back and he seemed to be fouled there. Argentina somewhat clutching at straws, just hoping to get the ball into the D and hit a Team GB player unsuccessfully. And 24 is Brunette and 8 is Ray. Ray again. 24 getting it wide there is Brunette. Shortly now the crowd will count down the last few seconds of this game. Argentina have the shot at goal, it's wide. Victory belongs to Team GB in their opening game. They've delivered it to their very happy crowd. Barry Middleton, the captain, popped up with a couple of goals. Daniel Fox and Richard Smith also on target. The only goal for Argentina scored by Pedro Ibarra. Only the top two qualify from this group. Great Britain have certainly made a promising start. Final score here, Great Britain 4, Argentina 1. So delight there for Team GB. Confirmation of the scoreline. And the goal scorers, Fox Smith, 4-0 to England. A very, very convincing win. Biggest win against Argentina was by 5-2 back in 1988. Argentina move on then to their next game against Pakistan on August the 1st. And a lap of honour for Team GB. They've deserved it. The GB crowd couldn't have wished for any more from their men's hockey team. Indeed, both men and women have made bright starts here. There's the opening goal, scored by captain Barry Middleton. One nil at half time. Reverse shot by Middleton, making it 2-0 to Team GB. Right through the legs of the goalkeeper. Daniel Fox making it 3. As Team GB threatened to run riot. 4-0. Richard Smith on target. Penalty corner to Argentina, and Ibarra pulled one back. So Team GB off to just about the perfect start, and they've overcome Argentina by 4-1.